I don't know if my. We're gonna have breakfast. We'll do a Tim Hortons run before the soccer game.
Do you wanna take a shower and I'll do your hair before the soccer game?
No.
Yes, you have to put
no,
on.
No, I'm washing something.
You can take a shower in 10 minutes then. Lola, don't argue with me.
I know. I love you.
You put it, you kept it over your head. Little baby and her pickle chips. Okay. Lola, it's time for you to take a shower. Time for you to take... You know what? I was gonna wait, but I'm gonna go get coffee real fast. I'm gonna do a coffee run and I'll be back in 15.
Where?
Tim Hortons. Do you want to come with me? Or do you want to share?
But can you get me a refresher? A strawberry refresher and
Dip donuts. Sven, do you want anything at Tim Hortons?
No, but... what's it called? I need more soap. Body soap.
Okay. Do you have enough yet left and I'll get more today or tomorrow when I go to the store? You ran out? Okay, I have some in my bathroom that you can borrow. Next time tell me when you start. What? Wait, you want me to get the $8 bar of soap off Amazon again? I'm gonna go to Walmart and see if they sell it, because some people said they sell it there. I have to do a coffee run, and my kids want donuts and refreshers. Nadia! I'm going to do a coffee run. Do you want to get anything? Do you want to come with me or get anything at Tim Hortons? Well, Lola doesn't want to come.
It's fine.
Okay. Thank you. Well, maybe she'll come if you're with us.
Lola, do you
want to go? Go convince her while I brush my teeth. I'll be live on Instagram while I do a coffee run. What was I going to do? Oh, I need my other phone. Guys, I have good news. More monetization tools have become available to me. So that's good. Because I've been kind of like fretting. I was going to curl my hair, but I need coffee. Okay, thanks. Put socks on. All right. We'll be back in 15. Lola doesn't want to join us.
Stay here.
Okay, I'll be right back, guys. Okay. I wasn't going to put makeup on, but now I'm going to. Should I put it on? I don't know, should I wear it or not? Should I put makeup on or leave it? Oh, I'm about to curl my hair or just leave it. Oh. One time this old man on Facebook, I made a post saying, if you're single, hit me up. Something like that. And this old man said, you have so much more talent other than belching and flatulating on the internet. And I'm like, how do you know that? Because I don't burp or fart on Facebook. He must watch my TikTok lives. I'll tell you right now. One of you trolls need to make a compilation video of me farting. I think that would be pretty epic. Should I curl my hair, put on makeup, or just let it go? Thanks for the roses, Kathy. Kathy, what were we talking about the other day? Palestine. I don't know where this is going, but They just want that canal. Oh, Kathy just said 50 roses and I said Palestine and then she stopped. Hopefully Kathy is on board against genocide. Oh, Gemicide. Imagine there's a girl named Gemma in here. The book. Yes, we were reading the book. Now, where are my nail clippers? Okay, so obviously I'm anti-genocide. And so I think that there's even people in the military, the United States military, begging for it to stop. Like, that's just how out of control the genocide is in Israel, or in the Gaza Strip right now. Where are my mother friggin' nail clippers? You're welcome. I'm glad we're on the same page. I've been saying this since the fake Hamas attack happened. I knew it was fake. I was like, this is propaganda bullshit. Hamas, no. It's Israel wants that strip. So there's a canal that will import and export goods, but Israel can't access it because they aren't in control of the Gaza Strip. So they are murdering innocent people because they want that strip. There's like an entire like history lesson about that canal. It's near this other canal. Oh, I'm rusty right now. Give me a couple hours. If you want me to make a video about it, I will. There's a fly in my car. I bet it come from the screaming house. It's probably from the screaming house. Because why is there a fly out here in the freezing cold? There's dead bodies around here somewhere, man. I'm telling you, that guy hoarding bodies. Matching towels. And then they saw a rock. It wasn't a rock. It was a rock. Lobster. Ah. The temperature is 39 degrees Fahrenheit. And there's a fucking fly across the street. Kill. Or no. Why did I say kill? I was gonna say get the fuck out. They can. Yeah, exactly. Bro, I need to get a video of that fly. Be like, it's 39 degrees. He has fly traps on his windows. And it's 39 degrees. Come on. Who's hosting the flies? Where'd that fly go? If that fly comes back, I'll make a video of it. All right. Do you guys like when I'm live in my car? Where'd the fly go? I should have gotten it on camera. Shit. I'm sitting in my car. It is 39 degrees Fahrenheit. The crows are going crazy in the background. And a black fly landed on my windshield wiper and started crawling around the window. I didn't catch the fly on camera. Because I'm actually live streaming. Wait. Whatever. Because I'm actually live streaming right now on TikTok. I'm watching this fly, listening to music, like nothing's happening. And then I think for a second, whoa. Why are there flies outside when it's 39 degrees Fahrenheit? And then my critical thinking wheels go into effect. Who has fly traps? Bro, I don't give a fuck. They have fly traps. Lots of fly traps. And okay, fair, fly traps. People don't want flies in the house. But why would anyone have flies in their house when it's 39 degrees Fahrenheit in the middle of fall? The end of fall. In upstate New York. In their basement? In their attic? Okay. And now I'm angry I didn't get a video of the fly. I wish I would have caught that fly on camera. If it could fly back right now, that would be a cinematic work of art. Okay. I'm sitting in my car. Dude, I don't care. I'm an asshole. I don't fucking care. I'm still not convinced. Now, the fact that a guy rode his bike past our house with a machete, and then I heard the screams 2 minutes later. What? It's weird. Tell me it's not weird. That a fly just landed on my window. Okay, now your name is Bug. That's even weirder. It is weird that a fly landed on my window. Man, these neighbors are gonna fucking... I'm next. No, they actually sent me a message threatening my kids. That's why I quit talking about it. I just went moot. I shut the fuck up. I really did. They blew up my Facebook, threatened my kids. Yeah. And I know their full name and everything. But they said, one of these days you're going to mess with the wrong person. If you haven't already, just remember you have 3 kids to think of. I'm not knocking on their door. That's just an invitation to get arrested. Hell no. I'm not scared of anyone. No fucking way. No way. Mm-mm. Not afraid. No one will ever fear me into being silent. Although they did silence me for several months. There's a legal boundary they can't cross. I'll never know who that screaming woman was. I know, right? For real, Rogue? Oh, there was a screaming house over the summer. But I was looking at the videos the other day in order. And I forgot. I saw a guy ride his bike by with a machete minutes before the screams happened. I made a playlist of the screaming house for a while. Dude, it got too intense. People started, like, spam calling the police. And the police never searched the house. They believed it was just a dog. This was the end of June, and the last scream I heard was July 9th. So June, July something, and then July 9th. July 5th? What was it? It was like June 26th. I'm looking at my calendar. So it was like June 26th, July 2nd, no, July 1st and July 9th, something like that. I'll never know what the screams were. It could have been the man fighting with his wife for all I know. But the screams stopped July 9th. They just stopped. But the fly traps are still there. What's with the fly traps? And they're on every window. Did you guys know this is like the most social media I'm doing right now? I'm like not into making videos anymore. But I'm glad that I still have you guys to chat with. It's kind of pathetic.
I have stretch marks. I hope no one sees me doing this because I'm in public, but they're visibly distinct stretch marks. Something I was widely embarrassed about.
I'm getting a little intimidated by TikTok and Facebook and all that. Okay, I just posted that video. Thanks for the hi bear. I should leave in a minute. I just got triggered. I posted a picture in a vegan singles group asking if there's any other night owls. And then I'm saying like what I'm looking for. And this jerk says, way to advertise your OF. I am so fucking sick of people saying that to me. I am so sick of it. Exactly, Jack. That's exactly what I'm thinking. Can someone tell me to stop arguing on Facebook lately? It's becoming unhealthy. I just got a notification from my cell phone provider that I ran out of hotspot data. Like, what is the difference between data and hotspot? I hate capitalism so much. I'm single. Duh. What is my current plan? How do I just get more data? Oh, they have 6-month plans. 1-year plans. How do I get more hotspot data? What do you want me to do about it, Black Wolf? I'm sorry, I like you. That's as much as I can do. People don't like me because I exist, if that makes you feel better. You just gotta tell them you don't like them. And then focus on the people you like. You people are a bunch of bullies. What are you gonna do about it? Now this guy. At least you're not this guy. Listen to this guy. Listen to what this guy said, okay? Be happy you're not this guy. Listen to what this man actually said, a grown man. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Because now I'm triggered. I should have taken a screenshot. I get along with folks that are younger as well. They're more alike socially and politically. Like, he's talking about girls that are between 18 and 20 to 25. Grown man in his 40s, 50s. Less baby boomer light in mentality. Less apt to be a bigot or religious. More empathetic. They're more open to new ideas and crazy things like science. No, it just sounds like they're open to you manipulating them because they're not matured yet. They've got less invested in the current system and so having not bought into it. They're less likely to defend things about current society that are not benefiting anyone. Younger folks are also more likely to be vegan and ecologically conscious, less driven by materialistic gains, and more experiential. They're also more likely to be open to different relationship styles as opposed to thinking that heteronormative monogamy is the only way. Okay, so you just want someone to be your slave, essentially. You want to be in an open relationship, polyamorous. And you want to find someone who will believe in everything you believe in. Now, I'm arguing with this guy. I hate Facebook. Someone tell me to stop. It is seriously draining. This idiot. You are making me angry. It sounds to me you want a polyamorous, you want a slave, a polyamorous relationship to bleep whoever you want. And a main partner who will allow you to manipulate their belief system and follow your lifestyle entirely without a second thought because they're too young and immature to have their own system of values yet. To have formed was predatorial. I don't give a fuck what you say. Predatorial isn't even a word, but I don't care. Like, this guy has me straight up triggered. I'm screenshotting it. Because I am bugging. This group chat sucks. You guys are all on here complaining about yourselves. Join a single in my 40s, 50s group and rant to each other there. This is a dating group. The intent, the dynamic, and focal point of dating is to flirt. So everyone, shut the fuck up, quit arguing, bitching, and start flirting with each other. This is so pathetic. I am embarrassed to be part of it. Dude, I'm raging. They're so pathetic. It's so pathetic. It's a vegan dating group with like 1,000 people, but only 10 people are raging. God damn! Literally, you could literally be flirting with the people you're sharing rants with. It's everything you want is right in front of you. If you take a step back, shut the fuck up, and look around. And then I'll do a : vegan singles dating challenge. Now I challenge you to shut the fuck up and select a male, female you're interested in. In flirting with. Bye! On that note, I have to take my kids to soccer. So I'm gonna go live on Instagram. Dude, I just like raged. Oh no, someone wrote back. Yeah, I don't give a shit. The flies are obviously attracted to dead bodies, and they're escaping the room with the dead. I'm going live on Instagram, so find me there. Except I ran out of hotspot, so I don't know what to do. What do you do? We'll see if I can connect. Bye.
Where is it?
How do you get a Facebook group removed? Like, taken down? I want that group banned. That group needs to go. Have a seat, Lola.
You can set it right in front of the banana. Thanks. If you want, you can have it. Did Grandma take her? She could have taken the staples, too. This group right here, hang on. Plenty of vegan singles. It needs to be taken down. No way. You want one? In the drawer. Mm. Wait, where's your donut?
It's in the...
You ate the donut?
No, I'm kidding.
Oh, you put it in the fridge?
No, it's in the living room.
Oh, you can eat it in here if you want.
Wait, you got those?
No, Grandma found this.
Oh, can I have it?
Yeah.
What?
Nothing.
Fruit strip.
What?
A fruit strip.
Rock. Cool rock. Isn't this rock?
Her dad dyed her hair. And yeah, thanks, it does look really cute. Brings out her blue eyes. What time is dad coming? Because we should go to the laundromat and wash your laundry from this weekend, and then you'll have clean clothes to go back with today. What? Mm. Why not? If they're out of the singles, you can open the package and buy them in singles. So, like, they sell the big boxes of them and the singles. You're allowed to open the box and to pick out some and scan the barcode. No. The boxes have the barcodes. Thank you.
Okay.
Next week's your last game, Nadia.
Mm-hmm. But there's winter playing.
Yeah, I'll sign you up again.
I want to stay on the green one.
Okay. I think you're allowed to, right?
Me and Lola were pretending to fake sleepies. We kind of heard you, like, going up the stairs, but, like, we didn't. Sorry, Lola, I ratted us out.
I kind of want to make a salad. Lola, Nadia wants you to go in the food pantry.
Okay. What?
Whoa. Rocking everywhere. tea, wrecking everywhere.
Booty, 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 booty.
I used to do that all the time.
Booty, 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 rocking everywhere. Booty, 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 rocking everywhere. Rocking everywhere. Booty, 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 rocking everywhere. Booty, booty,
okay. All right, I think I've got enough. What are you girls doing? Come on.
Let's do the booty walk, booty walk, booty, 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 booty.
Are these vegans?
Yeah. I bought them for us to eat. They're yummy and they're vegan. They're vegan for the vegan games.
Booty, booty, booty.
That's definitely haunted. Can I have your phone?
My phone?
Yeah, that one.
Do you want me to unlock it?
No, I don't need it unlocked.
Guess what, everyone? I put the milk first.
You pour the milk first?
Mm-hmm.
Booty, 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 rocking everywhere. Rocking everywhere. Rocking everywhere.
Bow, wow. Mrs. Baby, baby goo. Bow, wow. Booty, poo.
Booty, 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 booty.
What are you doing?
Booty, 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 rocking everywhere.
Okay, I'm done.
Booty, booty, booty.
Rocking everywhere. Rocking everywhere.
Okay, I got it. I don't know, you turned it the wrong way. I'm in New York by Buffalo. Oh, yeah, we're vegan. The sun is out.
These are so good.
They are delicious. I used to eat them when I was your age. When they were invented. What? That's not true. Nadia, you need to start putting your stuff away.
What stuff?
The milk.
Oh, that's
empty. Lola, will you pour me a glass of water, please?
No.
Please.
Here.
Thank you.
There's a flashing phone.
The flashing phone. Flashlights.
I'm getting some water.
Oh, really? So you're gonna have water, not me.
Why
this is a banana.
Why does it sink like that?
What?
Like that.
It's broken.
Like, stops.
We need to do your laundry. Maybe Grandma can do it real fast.
Yeah.
We'll ask her.
Dad's picking me up at, like, I think 5:32.
Okay. Can you tell him to come at 7:32 instead?
No.
Please?
No. That's not going to work.
All right, can I talk to Grandma? Okay, tell her to call this phone number. Okay, I love you, bye. I have 3 kids. 1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm.
Don't say that.
Why?
Because.
What does it mean?
It's just not. Don't ever. It don't, means, no, please don't. Don't.
It means cute.
Cute?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Well, still, just don't.
Mm-hmm.
Lola, that can literally get. Like, it's if a kid says something like that, and I tell them to stop, and they don't listen, it's just stressful. Like, why? Why do they have to be like that? Why do kids have to be like that? It sucks so bad. She just said a slur. That's all you need to know. A racial slur that I can't repeat. And she doesn't know it's a slur, because she's 8. But it's, like, stressful as fuck. I'm just trying to make a fucking salad, and my kid comes shouting in the... Yeah, it is, dude. It really is. Hello? Is there any way possible that I can come to your house and do Lola's laundry before she goes back to Kane so she has clean clothes for the school week? Okay, we'll be over there soon. And no, I haven't checked. I'll look right now.
It looks great. It looks really nice. Thanks for helping. What did you do with that big box? Oh, it's on the floor. All right. Thanks.
Yeah, we'll be there soon. I'm just making a salad. It really is a slur. How is it a slur? It just is. You don't have the choice to say it is or isn't. If it is, it is. And there's nothing you can do about it besides not say it. Yeah, it's stressful. Like, I just am trying to chat. I'm irritated today. Like, I hate Facebook. I hate Facebook. It makes me so angry. Like, the people on there are so... Ugh! Like, really? In what universe is it acceptable for men to admit they're being predators? In what universe? I just think that Facebook group needs to get banned. And I need a vacation. That's another thing I need. And I need guacamole. Sven, do you want a water bottle?
No.
You can eat the whole house. The food I buy is literally for you. Okay. You can eat everything. The only things I get weird about are my raw cashews and my protein bars, but that's why I bought a ton of them. So just as long as you leave me one. Yeah, it can be vegan as long as you buy vegan vapes. Jenna. Not in the mood. I'm so angry right now at that guy. Like, I'm so mad at that guy. Thank you, Tommy. Because this guy on a Facebook dating group started leaking private information that we shared in a private message. And that's illegal. That's fucking illegal. It's illegal. And the fact that he could just think he get away with it has me ready to call a fucking lawyer in the morning. Like, 100%. I'll put the retainer fee down. I don't give a fuck. Men need to be held accountable. Men need to be held accountable for their actions. You can't just break the law without, don't, like, I'm not the one to mess with, dude. Like, out of all the things I could sue someone in court for, that would be it. You even come close to leaking private information about me in a private conversation we had, it's game, dude. I will 100% take this motherfucker to court. The audacity. His name's John Quinet. John Quinet. Oh my god, why do you guys keep saying a girl got pulled over by cops? Like, who? Like, I don't care. Stop. Send me the person's name and then maybe I'll look at it. I literally don't care. Wait, this messed up. Like, be an adult. Like, are you fucking kidding me? Quit saying mukbang. I've told you once, and then I told you if you do it again, I'm muting you. That's rude. I'm not a mukbanger. That's fucking rude. I appreciate my food. It's not for my entertainment. I'm eating this as, like, I worship the food I eat. I'm grateful for it. Never fuck with my culture again. Those people who do fast food mukbangs and they put all this crap in front of them and they destroy their bodies and they have no self-worth would never be me. When I eat food, this is food that I worship, that I'm grateful for. It would never serve for your trivial, bogus entertainment. And if you say it again, you get blocked. Don't fuck with my culture. Anyway, I belong to a vegan Facebook dating group because I'm vegan. And these guys created a group chat. Thank you, Ashley. Antoinette, that's awesome. More power to you. Thank you, Maddie. Thank you, Sophia. I'm glad because I would never. I would never take food for granted, period. Like, it's just rude. It's distasteful. It goes against everything I stand for. It's just wrong. Mukbangs are wrong. And they're just, I don't. Like, the only time you'd see me possibly say vegan mukbang is if I sample foods at a Whole Foods salad bar, potentially. I've never had avocado. I've made avocado toast, but I've never bought it. Thank you, Emma. Me too. Me too. And that is not what this is. And it pisses me off when people get it twisted. That's just rude. And I'm offended by that. These men in the vegan dating group actually had a chat that they have to lie about their age to women in their early 20s. Like age group 18 to 24. 18 to 24. The men in this fucking Facebook dating group. Hold on. Let me find it again. Plenty of vegan singles. There are a bunch of men who are predators on the internet in this dating group saying that they're vegan. And they created a group chat complaining. Oh, I was stalking a gym employee and she didn't like me after she found out I'm in my 40s. She gave me her number. I didn't even ask. She really liked me. And then when she found out I was so much older than her. And then this other guy admits, oh, yeah, it's such a tough reality we vegans face. We look so much younger than our real age, so we have to lie. Like, they are targeting these young, innocent women.
Nobody.
So I rage, okay? I rage. And I tell them off. I'm like, get out of this chat. Like, that is grooming behavior. If you're single in your 40s and 50s and you exclusively, deliberately pursue young women ages 18 to 24, there's a reason why you're not finding a long-term relationship. Those people aren't ready for them, and it's very selfish and narcissistic for you to think that you can implant yourself. A 50-year-old man can implant himself into a 21-year-old girl's life and steal her 20s from her. That's wrong. So I argue with them, and I tell them off. Get out of here. This is a group for vegan singles. Dating. It's just to talk about dating. It's not to bitch and moan that you're in your 40s and 50s and girls that are 21 don't want you. The admin deletes me out of the group chat. This woman right here. This girl. She deleted me from the group chat. And she didn't delete the predators, the internet predators. Oh, and so the worst part is that this one guy in there starts repeating private details of our private conversation and threatens to leak pictures I sent him. And I told him off, dude. I said, what you're doing is illegal. And then he's like, I said, in the state of New York, he's like, good thing that's not my jurisdiction. I said, I will file a court petition and have it mailed right to your address tomorrow. Pictures of what? Me. Pictures of me. Private pictures of me. Dude's a psychopath, man. He's in his 40s threatening to leak someone's private pictures. Isn't that illegal? That's illegal. Because I trusted him like a dumbass. He said he was looking for a relationship and that he met... He checked every box I wanted except he didn't have long hair because he's bald. We start flirting, we start chatting, we send video and audio messages, talk on the phone, I sent pictures like a dumbass. Not like a dumbass, because I'm entitled to my privacy. You don't get angry for being called out for being a creep months later. Dude, he's sitting there blatantly admitting that he's targeting young women 18 to 24. And they aren't attracted to him when he tells them his age. Like, be upfront about your age then, buddy. Don't lie. Well, I won't do it again. I blocked him. But still. ...100% private. If you send someone... ...private pictures... ...it's illegal for them to share those private pictures. 100%. It's illegal. Yeah, you are. With nudes, you are. 100%. Exactly. Well, he threatened. Yeah, it is. It's illegal to leak someone's private pictures in an act of revenge. It is a felony. Because I didn't think about it. I trusted him. It's hummus. I figured he's 40. We have a lot in common. He seems to have his shit together. He's cute. I like talking to him. I don't know. I didn't think that he would turn into a complete psycho. I know, Nancy. You want to see who he is? I'll show you who he is. Maybe I shouldn't, because then maybe he really will leak them. Maybe I shouldn't. Should I show you who he is? Don't. It takes a certain kind of asshole to threaten. No, grouper guy. Men need to be held accountable. If you really think that I would belong to a group chat for vegan singles and sit there reading about how men lie about their age when they pursue young women in their 20s so they can groom them. That is grooming. Like, they're all over here having a discussion about how to get young women in their early 20s, 18 to 21. And they're raging that they have to lie about... They're like, oh, we're vegan. We're vegan, so we look younger anyway. It's pretty sad. Women think we're so young because we're vegan and we're healthy, so we look young. But But then when they find out our age is really 20 years older than they expected, they don't want to talk to us anymore. No, they don't want to talk to you because you're a liar and you're trying to groom them and you're literally targeting young women. It is sick. Well, obviously I didn't see his true colors until months later. I started talking to him in like July, August. Right, Maddie? I just joined this chat because they just created it for the group. Then they removed me from the chat. This is Guy in Wisconsin and John. Thanks for the love. But seriously, quit saying mukbang. Pisses me the fuck off. Because these men are using the fact that they're vegan to groom young women. Because it goes against everything I stand for. Christian, fine. But quit saying that. It pisses me off. Okay, there's a vegan dating group on Facebook. And they created a group chat on Facebook Messenger. Look, bro, I flipped out on these vegan guys. Like, I literally started freaking out. Hang on, I'll show it to you. All right, this guy says, I have a dilemma. Do we tell them we're 10 or 15 years younger and lie? Or tell the truth and have not a lot of women to talk to? I look 10, 15 years younger than my age. Young women act interested until they find out my age. Which leads into an uproar of men complaining that women in their 20s don't want them. And how they go about snagging young women, which is sick. I don't get along with folks I get along with folks that are young as well. They're more alike socially and politically. They're less baby boomer light in mentality, less apt to be a bigot or religious. More empathetic, more open to new ideas and crazy things like science. They've got less invested in the current system, and so, having not bought into it, are less likely to defend the things about current society that are not benefiting anyone. Yeah, because they're young, they're growing, they're like kids. If you're 18 to 24, your brain hasn't even developed. So all of these things he's saying are absolutely sickening, that he's trying to find a young girl to mold and manipulate and groom into a mold of his beliefs. Younger folks are also more likely to be vegan and ecologically conscious, less driven by materialistic gains, and more experiential. Women in their 30s, 40s, 50s, and 60s can fit these boxes. They're also more likely to be open to different relationship styles as opposed to thinking heteronormative monogamy is the only way. Oh, so he just wants to be polyamorous and hook up with as many people as he wants and find a nice young little girl who's obedient that he can mold into whatever he wants. Bro, the way I flipped out and started raging, I flipped out. Like, I went batshit crazy. I don't even know if I can say what I said. Nobody cares about age if they're Indio. If they're suddenly turned off, it's not by your age. It just led into this, like, upheaval. This isn't true. It sounds to me you want a slave, a polyamorous relationship, to bleep whoever you want, and a main partner who will allow you to manipulate their belief system and follow your lifestyle entirely without a second thought because they're too young and immature to have formed their own system of values yet. That's predatorial. I don't care what you say. This group chat sucks. You guys are all on here complaining about yourselves. Why don't you join a single in my 40s and 50s group and rant to each other there? This is a dating group. The dynamic and focal point of dating is to flirt. Bro, when I tell you, I started raging. So everyone quit arguing and bitching and start flirting. This is so pathetic, I'm embarrassed to be a part of it. You could literally be flirting with the people you're sharing your rants with. And this guy's like, I'm like, everything you want is right in front of you if you take a step back. Shut up and look around. Vegan singles dating challenge. Find someone you're interested to flirt with. Which spirals. Oh, someone had a sour cup of oat milk. Thank you. So at least someone agrees. All these vegan dating groups have been full of complaining and whining, not enough flirting. Such a shame we're forced to be here. And it gets ugly because the guy I was talking to joins. Where is it? He's like, wow, this is just bizarre. I know everyone had a bad day, and it really is lonely in the vegan dating scene, but wow. I'm like, this is my honest reaction reading your messages. You all need a reality check, and I'll deliver. I'm having an amazing day, but your messages are obviously a cry for help. Flirt with vegan singles or get out. I showed my friends these group messages. Even she agrees. And I know I look younger. That doesn't mean I use my youth and appearance to groom and manipulate men ages 18 to 24. I have no idea where she gets that from. I went back and was trying to figure it out. If you don't see that you have a problem when you say that you pursue young men and women ages 18 to 24, that's your biggest problem, dude. I can't share the rest because I literally started fucking raging. Like, I went into rage mode. And then that guy that I used to talk to was like, oh, you're just jealous because blah, 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 and you were asking me this and this and this. And then he shared private details of a conversation we had. And then the other vegan jerk had the audacity to say, where is it? Let's find it. Bro, did she send you any pictures of... And he's like, yes. And at that point, I flip shit. So you... Wait, not that. That was what I said to the admin. So then I rage. In New York State, if you receive a private... If receive private information that was sent to you privately and leak that content in any shape, way, or form, that's a lawsuit. So you better fucking watch it. I'll contact a lawyer Monday morning if you so much as speak about our private DMs again. And then the other guy was like, oh, I'm going to sue the vegans. I have the money right now. I will pursue legal action and I will document all of this. And then he said, LOL. Wait, no, that's not it. He said, where is it? Not that one. He basically said, that's not good thing, that's not my jurisdiction, but I don't know where it went. He's like, oh, well, good thing that's not my jurisdiction. It doesn't matter where you are. It is a crime. It is a fucking felony. It is a felony to leak pictures in retaliation. Like, that's a crime. It is crazy. And this is why I say men need to be held accountable. Because when they're called out on their disgusting actions, they can't ever own up to it. They just twist it around on the woman. No, they're on Facebook right now. He's threatening to leak mine. And he's sharing private conversations we had. Which is bullshit. I don't care. I blocked him. They weren't dirty pictures. It was just like a topless picture, but still. It's just the point. You shouldn't threaten to leak someone's picture. You know what I mean? Be an adult. Like, you're having an argument. He sent me pictures. I'm not over here saying, oh, I'm going to leak your pictures. Right. Well, after I sent the picture, I unsent it. So he probably didn't screenshot it anyway, right? Thank you, Gina. Exactly. It was on Facebook Messenger. I didn't say anything. It doesn't tell you when they take a screenshot on Facebook. He has the text messages. I hope not. It's just the point that he's threatening me and that he's already been sharing conversations. It's creepy. Like, if you have an adult conversation with someone, that conversation should stay between you and that person. Like, why would you repeat it? No, he didn't make me send them. I just sent them because we actually got along over the summer. But he turned out to be just not for me. Because he sent me all these crazy texts. And I'm like, this guy's nuts. So I blocked his phone number and kept him on social media. And I should have just blocked him when I blocked his phone number. If a guy leaks private pictures, that's illegal. Casey, shut up. Like, seriously, there's a difference between being a vlogger versus leaking someone's naked picture. Like, that's batshit crazy. That's not even comparable. It's illegal to get to seek revenge. Yeah, that's illegal.
Don't victim blame people. It's not, that's not it. It's illegal to leak pictures that someone sends you privately. Kiss my ass. Like, I'm not even going to argue. I need a mod. Mod. I need a bigger salad, too. I'm hungry. I'm, like, so fucking hungry today. I already blocked and muted them. It is illegal. Thank you. I made a video sharing the conversation in order. Talking about it. But I have to get going. I have to bring some laundry over to my grandparents' house. I'm too fucking irritated right now. Yeah. That, I mean, hopefully not, but this asshole started sharing private details about a conversation we had. And I use an Italian vinaigrette. I haven't eaten yet today, so I'm like starving. Look, I am so hungry today. Like, it's hunger. Like, I'm hungry. I need to exercise more. I'm not always eating, you dumb bitches. If I were always eating, I would be always live. This is my, it's 4 o'clock. I haven't eaten yet today. I'll be back. I'm going to restart the live after I block these people. The mods are not working right now. Like, it's just not working. They're not instantly blocking the trolls, and it's making me get angry. Like, you gotta, if you see them be dickheads, like, just block them. Why is that so fucking hard? I have to restart the live now. But I'm starving. Just straight up block people. If they say, you're always eating, just block them. Because that's just annoying. Protein bar. And then mute them. Like, block, mute, block, mute. Because it's dumb. It's like, why? Like, what's the point of even saying that to someone? Block Jordan right now. Like, I read that instantly, and I'll block them instantly. Like, I read it fast. I know, right, Maddie? Okay, thanks. I just don't understand, like, why people have to, why people care. It's not that I'm always eating. It's that I eat for, like, an hour when I eat. Right, Maddie? Thanks for the rose, Mr. Winners. Dude, wait, which guy? The one from... Yeah, she's talking about pedophiles on Roblox. The guy on my video? Yeah. It's fucking creepy. Thanks, Maddie. Wait, Sadie, is that... Were you from Kane? There is, but I never watched it. Okay, Squid. No, this guy literally admitted, I won't date women older than me. He's like, I can't date women older than me.
not even 5 years older than May, because that doesn't work biologically for reproduction reasons. Let me get this straight. You're in your 40s, you want to have kids, but you don't want to have a kid with a woman in her 40s? But you think you're entitled to having kids in your 40s? You're welcome. Keep them. If they leave her be. If people share their Cash App, keep them. But no spamming, Kristen. I don't care if people share their Cash App. He will be single forever with an attitude like that. And what's with these men in their 40s? Who literally their first sentence is, I want to have children. How do you feel? Do you feel comfortable with that? Like, what? Like, you don't even know this woman you're talking to on the internet. And you're like, I want to have children. I have dimples. He will be single forever. No, I'm never having kids again. Shake my head. Why? Exactly. Look at this. The admin of this group. She's not responding. Probably does. You know what the fucked up part is, that she has a teenage son? I'm so done with people. We need to all report that group. Like, massively report it. Let's do it. Let's massively report the group. There's just a bunch of internet predators in it. Go report it. No, I don't care about Reddit. You can talk shit about me on Reddit. I don't care. This is fucked up that there are men admitting to grooming women in this group. And they're getting away with it. And when you try to hold them accountable for it, the admins just remove you. So I can't be in a group chat in this group on Messenger. Because men are in there concocting ideas of how to convince young women in their 18 to 24 age bracket to like them. Because they're in their 40s and 50s. And I'm calling them out for being predators. I'm like, that is grooming. That is creepy. That's not what this group is about. If you're having trouble with your dating life, seek a therapist. They're like, you need a therapist. Who's shitting your Cheerios? I'm just calling it how it is. I'm a female. All women know that men are scary. We've seen someone get groomed at one point in time in our life. If we were ourselves hadn't been groomed. We at least know one woman who has been groomed by a man. So the fact that men are in this group complaining to each other.
Oh, I lie about my age. I have to lie about my age to attract women between ages of 18 and 24. I have to lie about my age for them to like me. And then if they find out the truth, they'll quit talking to me because I'm too old. But they never knew I was that old because I'm vegan. And I look young because I'm vegan. Like, are you fucking for real right now? That is. How do you report it? Let's find out. I don't know. I'm in it. I don't care if you're vegan. They're just using that as an excuse to be predators on women. Fucking internet predators, dude. It's loading. Hang on, I'm shutting the Wi-Fi off. My Wi-Fi is awful. Okay, you go to the group. I don't know how to report it. You can't. There's no way to report it. Oh, wait. We click on it. Go back. Look. Click the pink picture. Click the three dots. Report group. Did you guys catch that? And then we would put... I don't even know what category of report this would be. I would put nudity and sexual exploitation. That's what I would put. All right, so this is what you do. You go to the group. You click that. You click that. You click the picture. You click the three dots. Or wait, no. You go here, you click the waffle, then you click the three dots, and then you click report group. I don't give a fuck if I'm vegan. That group needs to go. Bunch of predators on there, and the admins are advocating for it. False information on politics. Yeah, they do, actually, share a bunch of politics in there, and I don't know why, because it's not vegan related. Dude, I don't care. That group is done. That group needs to go. I'll put harassment too. Men are on there harassing women. How do you report the group chat is what I'd like to know. Fucking losers. Thanks, Emma. This is what you do. You search for the group. You click the group. You click the picture. Or wait, no. You click the three waffles. I'm sorry. Three dots. Report. And then I would do this. Exploitation. In my opinion. Because that's what men are doing on there. They're literally targeting women on that app. I don't think I've ever gotten this riled up over a fucking Facebook group in my life. Like, the audacity for those admins to allow those men to groom women. Are you out of your mind? And have a safe spot for men to discuss how they can attract women ages 18 to 24. And then, right there, out in the open... Share personal private details about a private conversation you had with another group member and threaten to leak their private pictures? And these admins are okay with that? No, there's three women and one man. It is. It's super wrong. And thank you for reporting it. Guys, I gotta go. I have to take laundry over to my grandma's house. Bye. I'll be live.